Hello and welcome. This is Zain, and in this video lesson I'll be showing you like how you can manage your Shopify web store. So let's imagine this is your website and you want to manage the products, the different collection categories, and you want to add a new product to your store, or if you want to add a new collection to your store. So in this video lesson, what we'll do, like, we will create a new collection under the major category called women. So let's say we want to add a new collection called jeans under women. So to do this, what we'll do, like, we will go to the admin panel of your Shopify web store. Make sure you are logged in to the admin panel. Once you are logged in to add a new collection, before we initiate, I would like to explain about the collections. Unlike WooCommerce or Magento, in Shopify we have categories classified as collections. So whenever you want to add a new set of products, you should create a collection first, and then you can add different products to that specific collection. So to initiate, go to the admin panel of your website. From here, navigate to the products. Under products, you will see different submenu items. Click collections, and we want to create a new collection. We will name it jeans. Here you can write any collection description. You can add different images or videos to this description of that collection. Sales channels. Let's say, do you want this collection to be visible only on your online store, or do you want that to appear on your Facebook sales channel, Instagram or Messenger? This should be checked in, or this should be as it is by default. So collection type check. There are two options for this. One is manual, one is automated. If you select manual, then you will have to add all products to this category or this collection manually. When you are updating or you are adding a new product, you have to select this as a collection. The automated check will automatically add any product to this collection if it matches a certain condition. Let's say, we can define, like, either it should match all conditions or it should match any specific condition. Like, we can define, like, if product title contains jeans, the product should be automatically added to this collection. For the time being, we will select this as a manual collection type. Collection image. Here you can define a collection image. Yeah, once that specific image is selected and uploaded to the collection properties, you can hit the save button from the collection settings, and yeah, that will create a new collection called jeans. So to add that collection here, what we'll do, like, we will modify the navigation of your website so that collection should be visible here. To do that, we will navigate to the navigation of your Shopify website. Here we have two menu options. One is footer menu, the other one is main menu. The footer menu covers this specific menu. The main menu type is the major top level navigation here. So we want to add a submenu over here. So to do that, navigate to the women's, click add menu item to women. Name it jeans. Yeah. So from here we can define that as that newly created collection. So yeah, that is created. Click add, and this will add this newly created navigation under woman. Once done, you can hit the save button. So yeah. After that, you can check the main navigation again. See, so the newly created collection is visible here. Currently, there are no products in this collection. So what we'll do, like, we will now add a one manual product to this collection, and then we will add, or we will import some products from AliExpress to your Shopify website using an app called Uberloop. So to add the product manually, what we'll do, like, we will navigate to the products. Here we can hit the add product button. Let's say we can name it anything for the time being. Good product title. Description of this product. We can set any pricing here. $20 compared at cost per item. You can select here, like, if you want to charge specific tax on this product or not. There are different options here for this specific product, like, either if you want to track the inventory or you want to count the stock, you can select it here. Under shipping, this is a physical product. Yes. Weight, you can define here. If your product have different variants or different combinations, you can check this option here, and we can add various options here. Like, let's say we have different sizes of this item. So let's say we will add various options here, like sizes can be 32. Make sure to separate each option with a comma. 34, 36, 38, 40. XL, XXL. Yep. We can add another option, color. We can define here blue, black, white, brown. Okay. So now this product is basically created. Now what we'll do, like, we will add that product to our newly created collection called jeans. To do that, click here, and from here select jeans. Yep. You can add one product to multiple collections using this option. So for the time being, we will just publish this to our newly created collection. You can add different tags here, like vintage, fashion, summer 2019. Yeah. Besides that, you can define a different pricing for each variation of your product. So now we have defined a different price for this variation. So whenever a user will select this option as a blue and with 32 as a basic size, he or she will be charged 25 instead of 20. So once that is done, what we can do, like, we can add different images to this product. To add an image, click add images. So you can add any image over here. Adding images manually, you can add the images directly from another URL. So for the time being, this is done. So now we have the product live on our website.